I'm Emily Sandine Tate from the class of 1983 at the Air Force Academy, and I now live in Spokane, Washington. I started quilting when I was in like fifth, sixth grade with Girl Scouts. I always enjoyed sewing, and as a kid I would sew clothes for my dolls and my sister's dolls and my teddy bear. Actually, yeah, I can remember making some teddy bears for my nephews when I was at the Academy, and did some hand quilting when I was at Nav school, and when I'd be deployed, I could take things like that that I could hand quilt. So it just kind of kept with me, and I could call my kids when I was deployed, and they would talk about the quilt that they were holding, and they would know, oh, you know, there's love in this. Mom's, you know, Mom made me this quilt. The sewing has always just been my kind of calm place. The Quilts of Valor, it started in 2003 by a woman named Catherine Roberts, and she had a son who was deployed to Iraq. And it all came to her, well, she says in a dream, that she had this vision of a veteran just suffering with these war demons. And she was a quilter, and she thought, you know, that kid needs a quilt. And that kind of started it, that she thought that would help. And, you know, just kind of grew from there. They started just trying to do the wounded veterans, and then came to find that these Vietnam veterans really, it really meant a lot to them. You know, you don't have to have physical wounds. You don't have to have lost a limb. Just touched by war. And it brings comfort and just a little thank you. So this whole contraption is a long arm sewing machine. And it's called a long arm because it has this longer arm than you see on a traditional sewing machine. And so someone has put together a bunch of pieces of fabric to make the quilt top in some fashion or another. The quilting on something like this will take me probably 3 or 4 hours. If I'm doing something really intricate or like stitching right along these lines with a ruler and such, that takes much longer. I've spent, I think there was a quilt that I had some tiny, tiny stuff that I spent over 40 hours working on. So it's very dependent on how much thread you end up putting on the quilt. It is a national organization. We have awarded over 250,000 quilts to date. Once I learned to long arm quilt, it was a volunteer thing that you could do. And they picked up on me that I was a long arm quilter and reached out. And so I started quilting for other people. And the more I got involved, and I started making some for the Quilts of Valor, not just quilting tops that other ladies gave me, but I found that I really love the presentation part of it. I love making the quilt, the whole process of it, but when you go and tell a veteran how important they are to you, so important that you put hours into a quilt for them, and many women put hours into that quilt for them, and family would come. We try to do it at a VFW, at a meeting. So there's some recognition for the veteran, and, you know, tell them about their service. Lots of times people don't know, grandkids, kids don't know that they had a Purple Heart or other things like that. People say that after they've gotten them, we've had people tell us, no one's ever thanked me for my service before, especially the Vietnam vets, or that kids or the parents and stuff, he never told me about that. I didn't know about that. But, you know, I heard the story of a guy who went home. You know, he'd never said much of anything. He went home and he napped under that quilt, and it was like the first rest when they saw him like relax. And it just gives them a feeling of that people care, that people notice, that we, you know, people that don't even know them care and thank them for their service.